Video Games Recon.
Hello and welcome. My name is Nate from Video Games Recon, and in this video we're going to discuss all the current Advanced Warfare weapons in this class, and then pick the best or my favourite weapon in said category. First off, if you've already seen this intro in a previous review video, feel free to skip ahead to the time on screen. Also, each weapon will be reviewed or discussed as the basic model, and not including any of the upgraded versions. And please keep in mind this is just my humble opinion, and due to your playstyle, your opinion may differ, which is perfectly fine, and in such case, please don't rage out and lose your shit. Instead, feel free to post your thoughts in the comments. Anywho, without any further ado, let's do it to it. Okay, so as per usual, I'm going to pick my favourite launcher from this class. First off, let's discuss launchers in general within Advanced Warfare, as there aren't as many aerial killstreaks as previous incarnations of Call of Duty, excluding Ghosts. And the ones that are tend to get deployed less frequently, and therefore there is less of a need for launchers in general. Unless you want to help out your teammate by downing often large numbers of enemy UAVs. And in terms of blowing up enemy players, in most cases taking up a precious slot from the Pick 13 system with a launcher often feels like a waste, as they have limited ammo and little use in most game modes. That's not to say they're irrelevant, just that they're only needed in fairly rare and specific circumstances, or unless your team is getting hammered. With that, let's quickly go through the weapons before I pick my favourite. First up, there's the Stinger M7, which is very reminiscent of the Javelin from Modern Warfare 3 and the FHJ from Black Ops 2. The Stinger is pretty much your basic lock-on rocket launcher, except with a horizontal fire spread of 4 rockets with each shot. Next is the MAAWS. This is a free-fire shoulder-mounted launcher with laser guidance. Basically, it has no lock-on, but when you fire the weapon and then ADS after the rocket has been launched, you can guide the missile towards the target you're currently aiming at. In theory. In real terms, that's easier said than done. And lastly, we have the Mayhem. Not a huge amount to say about this weapon, as it's a fire and forget launcher that shoots projectiles of molten metal. So, no guidance and pretty much does what it says on the tin. Cause mayhem. So, onto my favourite weapon. Well, the MAAWS is pretty much useless, as it's junk at taking out aerial killstreaks and average at taking out players. But with only one round, it falls short in both cases. The Mayhem is pretty decent at taking out enemy players, particularly on objective game modes, but is useless at taking out aerial killstreaks due to its lack of guidance and slow projectile speed. So, the winner of this category, in my mind, is the Stinger M7, as it is leaps and bounds ahead of the other two launchers in terms of taking out aerial killstreaks, with its trusty lock-on, and is fairly decent at taking out enemy players, particularly at long range. However, I feel they missed a trick here without being able to use indirect fire akin to a javelin, as that would be very useful seeing as the maps in this game often have obstructions on the lines of sight, sometimes due to the new verticality of the maps. That said, this is by far the best launcher and probably my easiest decision thus far. But never mind what I think, what do you think of the guns in Advanced Warfare so far? Feel free to post your thoughts on the weapons in this class in the comments section. So, that just leaves me to say if you enjoyed this video, please help support us by liking, sharing, favouriting and subbing for more BS of a similar nature. Thank you, and goodbye.